Hey, what's up, guys? Hey, Parkies and Ken. Kens. Whoa, I am like falling asleep today. Oh my god. If I actually leave this in, I just want you to know I didn't get enough sleep. Tip 2. Hey, what's up, guys? Hey, Barbies and Kens. And welcome back to the channel, our channel. And if you're new here, my name is Gab. And I'm coming from you today from my bed, as you could see, because I am exhausted. And I have a new ring light on the way coming from Amazon. I'm using my little tripod. And I figured, why not just lay in my bed and talk to you about. This is like honestly ridiculous. I seen H. Grey talk about it. I seen some other people react to it. And I was like, I need to react to this girl because I've never seen somebody so privileged in my life. And then try to like spin it and go back on it. And it's kind of funny. And especially during like the pandemic and hard times, people doing this kind of shit, it's just. Why? So if you guys are new here, please thumbs it up and subscribe down below to become a Barbie or a Ken. And then also I have a second channel, a vlog channel, and as we know, my Instagram, TikTok, all that. But I want to show you what we're talking about today, the person we're talking about, and why I'm like losing my mind thinking like I'm not crazy. You have to hear this.
It doesn't really matter how much money you make or how much money you have. That's really the thing, because I'm not asking you for a large financial contribution. If it costs $20 to sub, $20 is quite a bit of money. $20 is you can get a full meal for $20, and the difference of $20 and eating a meal is in that $20. Like, that's where it is. But a sub is $5. At maximum, in whatever your currency is, it's maybe $10. And it doesn't matter how broke you are, if you have time to watch Twitch, you have $10, truly. If you don't have $10, you probably don't have time to watch Twitch because you should be working. You should be trying to earn money. It's not a ton. It's not like a ton of money.
So basically, she's trying to get people to sub to her because maybe nobody does, or no, she doesn't have a lot of them. But the way that she comes off to say it is quite freaking ridiculous, especially like I said, in a pandemic. I think it's funny that she could just, without even thinking, be like, oh yeah, you're just sitting at home watching Twitch. So if you can't give me money, if you're just sitting at home, like, is Invader Z on another planet? That she just doesn't realize that, like, we're all sitting at home because people are laid off and we're staying indoors, like they're telling us, because of the pandemic. Like, I don't. Like, her sarcasm is so not cute. And if it's supposed to be satire, like, it's not. I read her bio. I went on earlier to see, like, what she was all about. And she's on a comedy channel, so I don't really know what she's like getting at.
So being like, I'm broke, I can't afford to sub, that doesn't really track. What you mean to say is, I'm so irresponsible with my money, I can't support the entertainment that I enjoy. That's what that is. I'm unemployed, so basically all my money goes to bills and food, or I would support you. It's $5. It's really like you're not gonna, no one's gonna convince me that what I'm saying is so rude or so unacceptable or so outrageous.
Okay, well, I'll convince you that it's rude. People that support you, who are on watching you when you're streaming, writing nice comments, and then you're gonna be like, it's only $5. I mean, it's only $5. It's like how she just keeps trying to justify to make people feel bad. Again, when we're in a pandemic, like if I was watching, I would have clicked off. Oh, I should be working to get the $5 to watch you. Okay, I would click off. Like,
It just simply isn't. It's $5. It doesn't cost you that much to sub. And it's very, very wonderful because it allows streamers to continue supporting their communities with content. That's all.
so I have this crazy notion. Why don't you get a job and then you can do your content on the side and have money for your own bills instead of making people feel bad while we're in a pandemic and they're trying to pay for theirs? So you could still make content. You could just have a regular job and not sit at home, you feel me? And then you don't have to beg and you don't have to look like.
Oh my, so here we have some excellent 300 IQ comments from the Peanut Gallery. This conversation sucks. This is weird. Yikes. These are exquisite contributions to a very good conversation. And these people in chat who are making these comments do not appear as immature, childish cheapskates whatsoever.
So here we have her calling her subscribers, or not even subscribers because they won't pay the $5, but people who enjoy watching, for a reason, her stream, calling them names because they won't donate, again, a simple $5 to Invader V because she doesn't want to get a job.
They're just sitting here masturbating as hard as they possibly can, as quietly as they can, because their parents are in the next room talking about how disappointed they are in them. And they're like, why would I ever pay for this when this slut's giving it away for free? You're right, buddy. You're right.
I think it's funny that she sits there and thinks people are doing that to her when everyone's just, like, making fun of her. And I don't... How full of yourself do you have to be? I'm just wondering. I'm asking for a friend. I'm gonna, like, sit up a little bit for this part because this is where it gets real. Now, the clip I'm gonna show you is from a completely different day, okay? Like, completely different day. She has different clothes on. And how she, again, is talking to the people who support her is absolutely disgusting. Like, wow.
Your favorite streamer because you're not subbed to me. And that just seems, you know, I don't know if there's really evidence to your claim. I'm a highly emotional person, and so I see that. And my first instinct is, yay, I'm your favorite. That means that I'm the best. But I also need to realize that because I'm a highly emotional person, that can lead me to being taken advantage of very... What's your audience's average age? Oh, I have no idea. I only really keep track of the people who support me. And the people who support me are usually men in relationships or actively dating between the ages of, I think, 25 to maybe 42.
If you hear a shower going, Buggy just came home and jumped in the shower. But basically, I just, like, can't even... Why does she know, like, the ages? She's like, well, I think they're blah, blah, blah. Like, why do you... And they're dating people. Like, that's really... That's creepy.
Mm-hmm. They usually work in tech. A lot of engineers are in here right now. It's really crazy. The other day when we were talking about like what we all do for a living. Oh no, so when you guys don't know to me, it tells me your name that is attached to your PayPal. And if your name is attached to your PayPal and you don't know to me, I look you up on Google. I Google each and every one of your names and I creep your LinkedIns.
Like I said before, I think she should go back to work. I think she has a little bit too much time on her hands because she's creeping people's... That's like people who donate to my Patreon, me just like taking their name because I have their email, their last name, and just looking them up and being like, oh, you work for blah, blah, blah. Oh, you work for cable company. Like, that's creepy. That's really weird. I don't know. Is that just me? I think that's weird. I think that's really weird. And maybe that's how she knew they were single or not, because she's looking them up on Facebook too. I wouldn't be surprised.
A lot of engineers. It doesn't really matter how much money you make or how much money you have. That's really the thing, because I'm not asking you for a large financial contribution.
So here's where it's gonna get interesting. She apologizes, okay? This is her apology. Are you ready for it? By the way, I don't know if I like where I'm filming today, only because my shelves aren't done. We're moving, as you know. I don't know if I like where I'm sitting. I could be like, I have a dress on, so my hoo-ha is gonna fly out. But I like that. This is nice, kind of, right? Am I turning it to black and white? Because it's gonna turn into a sob story, though, for this girl in like 2 seconds. So let's do a black and white. Hello, guys.
You're here right now because you've seen a clip of me and you're very angry about what I said in that clip. And you're justified in your anger. What I said was tone deaf, insensitive, and stupid. And I recognize that. I recognize that there is no context that I can give that would excuse what I said, so I won't. I can only own what I said, and I will. The clip that you saw does not represent my true feelings. I've streamed for hundreds of hours, and I've said, support communities after you support yourself first.
I see.
Subscribe if you have the disposable income to do so. But in that clip, I expressed opinions that I do not hold at all. I said things that I don't mean, and they were vile. I recognize that. What I said was wrong in any context, but especially in the context of a global pandemic. I know that you've lost jobs. I know that you're afraid for your own security, and I know that what I said was incredibly hurtful and wrong. And I take responsibility for it. I won't try to make excuses, and I won't deny that what I said was awful. I want to talk to you. I want to hear your voices. I want to answer the questions that you have. And I want to be able to do it in the most responsible way possible. So I have probably a lot of questions. I would love to answer them for you. They might get lost in what everybody else is saying in chat. So I ask that you're patient with the moderators as they work through what everybody is saying. Sorry for my silence. I'm just waiting to hear from you in a constructive way. Okay, so far, my moderators have told me that we don't have any specific questions. That's okay. I think a lot of people right now want their opinions to be heard, and that's what's happening right now in chat, and that's fair. You are allowed to feel exactly how you feel about what I said. So, we do have one question now. V, in the clip you stated that nothing could change your opinion, so why do you have a different opinion now? Would you have the same reaction if the video didn't go viral? The clip that you saw does not represent my true feelings. It was not the right way to deal with the situation. I don't hold that opinion. Not truly. That $5 isn't a lot of money, because I know from my own experience that $5 means so much to different people. $5 is the difference between having a meal and having a roof over your head and not. $5 means different things to each individual person. Congus, so what comes next? Where do we go from here, Invader V? Respectfully, why did you feel the need to make the comment in the first place? Why did I feel the need to engage in that argument? There's no good reason. There's no good reason for what I said. I was engaging in a bad faith argument at the time. And engaging in a bad faith argument is only going to bring forth bad faith arguments. I shouldn't have engaged with that person in the first place. I shouldn't have said it. Absolutely, I should have seen the comments in chat being made, and I should have been the bigger person to go above them, instead of stooping very, very low, lower than even what they were saying in chat. Because I'm the one who's responsible, my face is on the screen. I have the accountability, and I did not hold the responsibility of that space at that time. This didn't blow up. Would you still feel the same? You mentioned you would never change your opinion, Invader V. Yes. I doubled down on a very bad opinion. When I said, you're never gonna change my mind on this, I was speaking from a very narrow-minded place. It wasn't the right opinion. It wasn't even my real opinion. It was what I was saying in the moment to stoop low. I thought about that as well, because I had friends reaching out to me saying, this clip of what you're saying, it's satire, right? Like, you don't mean what you're saying in that clip. But it didn't feel right for me to play the card of, I was just joking, bro, because what I said wasn't a joke. What I said was hurtful. And it wasn't a joke. And although I was repeating negative things, it wasn't done satirically. It wasn't done tastefully. It wasn't done well. No, I'm not going to say it was a joke because it wasn't. My behavior in that moment made me the joke, but I wasn't making a joke at that time.
So she's basically saying she did it to hurt people during a bad time in American history to put a bad taste in their mouth, but also to get some extra coin because, again, she didn't want to work. She just went to sit at home. But she yells at people for watching her who sit at home. Do you see where the... Yeah.
What made you realize the problem? Even as I was saying it, I could hear the insensitivity in my voice.
She should change that to... What made me realize the problem? Well, the video went viral on a lot of platforms, and then I had to come up with an apology to seem like I wasn't entitled, because as you could see from this clip, she didn't do it one time. It wasn't like just like a one-time thing where she was like, ha ha ha, somebody got her mad. She did it on another stream. She was talking bad about people. So like, I think it's a matter of you got caught.
And I pushed away my conscience in that moment with the justification that I'm tired, I'm impatient, I'm frustrated with this conversation. I want it to end, and I want to hurt somebody in the end of this conversation. And what I said accomplished exactly that. It did hurt many people to hear what I said, and it showed that I was severely lacking compassion.
Let me just clear something up for you. I don't think you hurt anybody. I think you made yourself look stupid, honestly. I think everybody was just laughing at you, and you were the joke. Wow, you're trying to make a joke out of people who actually supported you.
Severely lacking compassion in that moment. Did you double down on this conclusion due to some past experiences? I noticed you got emotional when reading the comments on one of the clips. So my own experience is that I grew up very poor. I think it was interesting to see the assumptions that people made about me based on the clip that they watched, that I grew up very wealthy, that I come from privilege, that I was born with a silver spoon in my mouth. Anyone who has been on my channel for a period of time outside of this would know that I grew up poor, of a single mother who was an immigrant. English was her second language. I have a brother who also grew up poor with me. We understood the value of work. We understood the value of a dollar.
That was one of my key favorite parts of the apology. I grew up poor, so I know what it feels like. Just like you guys. But regardless, how about that $5? How about that $5? You're in the age group 25 to 52 or something. No, $5 donation. I can't do. Wow, we have a lot of inventors in here. We got a lot of inventors. I looked up their email.
The comments that I made in that clip reflected a very dark part of myself, which is despicable, truly. Don't know how many other ways I can say that I recognize that what I said was very wrong, and my words. With all due respect, why didn't you apologize before the clip blew up? Okay.
Actually, I'm sorry. I think this is my favorite part of the video because she's like, shit, because she's live, so she has to like think this up, you know, on the spot. So they're like, oh, well, why, you know, when the video gets popular and goes around, then you want to apologize. She's like, well, you see. She should have just been like, I got caught and I had to apologize for my actions that I've been doing in like a bunch of live streams because I'm just such an insensitive person because I grew up poor. Like, don't you think if you grew up poor, you would realize not to be a f***? Don't you? I don't know. That's just me.
That's a difficult question to answer. Preemptively talking about a bad take quite often for a lot of streamers will highlight it more than if they let it lie. So there have been other statements that I've made on stream that have been questionable. If you stream for any amount of time, eventually you'll put your foot in your mouth. And so that's happened before. I suppose I didn't apologize immediately after making those comments because I didn't realize the gravity of hearing them.
So in conclusion, this 30-something-year-old woman did not know she was a f- She had to actually listen to the video back to realize, wow, I'm a wow. The way things work in life sometimes, let me tell you. So, if you guys like this video, or if you're just as happy as I am that it's freaking over, please thumbs it up. And like I said before, subscribe down below. We will have a more traditional background next time. It will not be me coming from the my bed. But, you know, I've been not feeling up to par lately. I'm not feeling at my 100%. When the hell do I ever? But lately, I really haven't been. So, yeah, I will have my nice little background next time. Maybe we'll do bed videos in the future because, like, I just, all my stuff's in storage. We can put that over there, right? That'll look cute. But, and that's also an issue. That's also an issue. All right. I'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.